Okay, Ben Stein, can we see a Scott Brown, Sarah Palin ticket in 2012? Politics can change overnight.
What do you make
of Massachusetts?
Scott Brown is a superstar. I have never seen a person burst upon the national scene so fast and so powerfully as this man. He says all the right things. He's a great-looking guy. Got a lot of self-confidence and a lot of modesty at the same time. Sarah Palin is yesterday's news, a very nice woman, and has got the right heart on a lot of issues. This guy is a meteor. This guy is so bright, it's unbelievable. Massachusetts may be a cradle of presidents again.
Mark, he's got to be up for re-election for the Senate in 2012. Does he go national?
Well, look, I think it's too early. I don't think this election was as much about him as it was about, you know, the voters, you know, wanting to express that they've got, you know, tough times, high unemployment, high deficits, and sending a message to Washington. So I don't know whether it's going to be about him or about the message that was sent out of that election, but I think it was mostly the message.
Ms. Cupp, doesn't it appear he is on his way, though, politically? I mean, he's so fast, he's on the scene.
Absolutely. He's a superstar. And what happened in Massachusetts this week was the political equivalent of the Boston Massacre. And anyone who tries to spin it differently is just wrong. But conservatives need to be careful. He has yet to serve a single day in the United States Senate. Let's wait and see if he can prove us right before we anoint him as the next great right hope.
Stephanie, what's the effect of that election on legislation like health care?
I don't know, Larry, but I know things have changed when the Republicans elected a former nude model who tried to auction his daughters off at his victory speech. That's a little bit of a change for the Family Values Party. You're right. And I think that he has run as an obstructionist, like the rest of his party. He has run as I'm the 41st vote against everything. So, you know, I'm not sure how this is different. I agree he's good-looking and charismatic, and I think Martha Coakley, unfortunately, was just not a good candidate. So I don't know how, you know, if this is the end of civilization as we know it, as a lot of the Republicans like to cast this.
Mark, do you think there will be a health bill coming forth?
Well, I think there'll be a health bill, but I think that it's really going to be changed over time here. I think this election says that there's a lot of opposition to this bill, a lot of concern about it. You know, I think that, you know, that you may take a step-by-step approach, might be a wiser approach in these things. I think people are looking for some progress first on the economy before health care, and so I think this is going to be a process that now gets considerably slowed down.
Ben, what's the effect on the president, who apparently retains his personal popularity?
I think the effect on the president is to say, go back to square one and say, look, the country has got a really bad recession. It's not getting better as fast as we thought it would. The foreclosure crisis is still a crisis. Let's concentrate on that. Let's put everything else on the back burner. Put America back to work. Do all you can to do that. Worry about these other ideological issues later. Get Americans back to work.
And Ms. Cupp, what do you make of the president and his standing right now?
It's not good, Larry. I think you can tell by his spinsters. You know, they're trying to market him now as a populist, which is hilarious. The guy who made fun of Scott Brown for driving a pickup truck is now suddenly a man of the people. I think they're desperate, and I think what they should do is have the president start over, as Ben said, come back to the middle, be the centrist that he was elected to be, and start listening to the voices of the American people. Incorporate a lot more bipartisanship, whether it's on health care or jobs or the economy, but open his ears.
Okay, we got lots more. We'll be doing a lot of this all next week. Thank you. Yeah, we will, Stephanie. We'll have you back. Thank you all.
Oh.